direct.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
We've got it.
This transmission is coming to you.
Waging war on corruption.
All right, you want to go?
It's Alex Jones, coming to you live from the front lines of the info war.
Hey, Barack Obama. He's been elected again as the 44th president of the United States. It, of course, is Sunday, November 4th, 2012. He hasn't been elected to his second term yet. But if you looked at the bookies in Vegas, Ireland, and England, they're already paying out on it. And that's a real attempt, from my view and my research, to influence things and to make it look like a foregone conclusion from a historically very, very seedy industry, you can call it that. We're going to be going over that report. The New York Times says 85% chance that he's going to win and use one of their pet pollsters to say that. Look, I know Mitt Romney's a globalist. I know he's New World Order all the way. The issue is Barack Obama won't be facing re-election. He'll have the power of the pardon and the power of the executive order, and he's got a total criminal crew up there under him that is going to go for broke. They've said they've only shut down 200 coal power plants, roughly. They're going to shut down over 1,000. They've publicly said this as soon as he's reelected. And he's now said he will move to ban extrajudicially your handguns and rifles, not for manufacturer sale. They're going to order them turned in. They want to start a civil war. This is a criminal group. Now, he's a puppet of the globalist, you know, and that's why the system really wants to get Obama back in, because they believe he'll just do whatever he's told and move forward. Romney will have more trouble with his constituency doing it and will be facing re-election. I always say throw the bums out. You know, I sat on the benches with McCain and Obama because it was not an incumbent and said either way it's going to be horrible. But clearly, clearly the power structure wanted Obama 4 years ago, and that's why I made the Obama deception, and of course he won. This time there is some splits in the power structure, but still the main power structure wants Obama, and we're going to be breaking all this down today. Also, you know, I monitor mainstream media. It's a tough job, but somebody's got to do it. And Bill Maher has more race baiting, more calls for race war in this country, and it dovetails with Michael Moore. It dovetails with what we see from MSNBC and the fact that more threats to attack white people, more threats to attack and burn things down are being allowed by the Secret Service. Really, nothing's being done about that. There's a new Weekly Standard out report dealing with that from the Weekly Standard. But coming up, we've got some clips here. Well, the new clip of Bill Maher saying, hey, if you don't vote for Barack Obama, white people, black people are going to come and attack you. And it's real cute and it's real funny, making it racist if you don't vote for Barack Obama. Just amazing. It was white people in massive record numbers voting for Obama that put him in office. And that was a fair election. It was somewhat of a landslide. You know, we monitored it. No need for the power structure to use a lot of fraud there, because who they wanted got in. And so, oh, you've chosen who we want. Well, that's okay. And again, McCain wasn't good either. He was a placeholder, like somebody in a professional boxing match run by the mafia, where, you know, there's a guy who's going to win and there's a guy that gets in there and takes a dive. John McCain is basically a Democrat posing as a Republican. And the Republicans are globalists posing as Republicans. So we're in deep trouble either way. But in my gut, and also intellectually, I know that we're going to be facing more trouble probably from Barack Obama. I'll also be honest with you, and I've talked to a lot of big talk show hosts and other people off record, at least in the short term, higher ratings, more AM and FM affiliates, you know, the star of this show rising faster if Barack Obama gets elected, because people are going to stay more awake and angry and upset. Mitt Romney gets elected, sleepy time happens. And so, again, I still don't want Obama to win, though, because I care about freedom more than having a big radio show. We'll be right back. Stay with us. Alex Jones here with a message to fellow freedom lovers. The prognosis for the entire planetary economic system runs from bad to worse. The globalist model is to shut down societies and starve patriots out until they acquiesce to the global takeover. That's why we've assembled the most vital and important preparedness items at InfoWarsShop.com. These are items that I did research on, that I personally use. We've got the Life Straw, so you can turn fetid water into safe water anywhere you go. The K-Tor hand crank generator to charge up key equipment during power outages or out in the field. Strategic Relocation, 3rd edition by Joel Skousen. When Disaster Strikes by Matthew Stein. TheraSafe, used by Homeland Security to protect yourself during any radiological event. Hand crank shortwave AM/FM radios. Everything that we've researched and found to be the best is available at InfoWarsShop.com, and your purchase makes our InfoWar possible. We're getting prepared. Are you? InfoWarsShop.com.
We now take you live
to the Central Texas Command Center
in the heart of the resistance. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
Welcome, my friends, listening across the United States on the AM and FM dial, and all of you out there across the world listening on Global Shortwave, WWCR, World Service, 100,000 watts, heard planetary-wide. And, of course, all the people listening at PrisonPlanet.com, InfoWars.com on the free audio streams, and later on the giant podcast. It's in the Alex Jones radio show section if you'd like to subscribe for free. And everyone watching us, the video feeds at PrisonPlanet.tv and InfoWarsNews.com. I want to thank you all for joining us on this November 4th Sunday transmission. Now, 48 hours out from the thick of the election, 48 hours from now, we're going to be Tuesday evening right in the middle of this. And this is an election to remember, even though both candidates are bought and paid for by big mega banks and globalist institutions. There are some real differences in the management style, the globalist management teams that are behind them. And Obama is saying all churches will hire non-Christians, and you will pay for insurance and abortions. Total violation of the First Amendment. Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. Separation of church and state means the government has no jurisdiction over religion. Not religion can't be involved in public life. But that's because I am a person that studies history and has historians and constitutional lawyers on. They use the pure ignorance of the public to think that churches can't have any political speech. No, the government cannot have a religious position that you're forced to follow. This country was founded by Christians who believed in free will and said you don't have to be a Christian. But now they've turned it around backwards to wage war against Christians and tell Catholic churches nationwide you will pay for abortions. Travis County, where I live. Travis County, where I live in Austin, this transmission is coming to you from Austin, Texas. I run into people all the time that are visiting Austin. They go, you live in Austin? I thought it was New York or L.A. That's where all the media lives. I listen and watch every day, they say. Well, listen, I'm in Austin, Texas, right here in the middle of the country. So we're coming to you from here. Travis County is the only county in Texas, great state of Texas, my beloved state, where they take your tax money in the hospital district money and make you pay for people's abortions. They're $400. They're subsidized because the elite don't want you being born. If you want one, you pay for it, okay? Don't make me pay for it. It's real simple. All right, continuing. You ever heard of separation of church and state? I hope that you would actually live by it. Oh, but you use it to eradicate religion. The point is, under Obama, he said in the last debate, he said, I will come after, it was the middle debate, I will come, we've played the clips, we will come after, he goes, I don't want to just ban semi-autos. He goes, I want to ban handguns. And that's what his attorney general has supported, that's what he supported, that's why they shipped guns into Mexico to blame the Second Amendment. CBS News even got those internal memos, okay? That was a false flag frame-up on the Second Amendment, an inside job. Fully autos, hand grenades, not just stuff out of gun shops. And you're going to get over 1,000 power plants shut down. That's now been reported on by the Associated Press. They've only shut down 200 and something, massively increasing power prices, coal power plants. They're going to shut down over 1,000. Of course, the big insider ones that are given waivers, like General Electric, their profits are going up. You're going to pay a lot more for less. That's the old Enron scam out of California and Oregon, where they were making $2 billion a day sometimes running scams. So that's what you're going to get. Now, again, am I saying Mitt Romney's a good, great guy and I love him or I'm running out to vote for him? Well, number one, Texas is going to go Republican anyways by a landslide. So if you knew anything about the Electoral College, you'd know it doesn't matter. Plus, Travis County, again, where I live, has been proven and certified. Back in 1998, I was there at the county commissioners where I proved fraud and a fraudulent election. And they with the county commissioner and the state said it is fraud, but we still certify it. That was in the Austin American Statesman. So I don't have voting, okay? That's why they'll probably pass Prop 1 to make UT that's got, what, $4 billion in its permanent fund and oil wells everywhere to make me pay them billions of dollars, the average taxpayer, $200-something a year forever, to pay for a new medical school for them when it's the richest university in the world. That's why they can get away with anything here. I'm sorry, I'm now ranting. That's why we're an official UN city under UN control. Look it up on the UN's website. Just type in Austin, Texas on the UN website. We are the city worldwide, the example. Because the parasites all come where the wealth and liberty is and take it over. Austin is wonderful. It's the best of worlds, the worst of worlds. The best of times, the worst of times. But none of that is what, that's not the big news here today. I want you to call your friends and family right now, right now. Whether you're listening on News Radio 590 here in Austin, Texas, or the big station there in Knoxville, all of our great affiliates, what is it, WNOX? I can't keep track of all these affiliates. By the way, they gave me the affiliate list the other day, and it's not even updated. It was like 140-something stations. So I'm just trying to, you know, get my mind around that and try to get all the stations down. The point is, whether you're listening in Chicago on 1530 or whether you're listening in Rochester, New York on 1320, or whether you're listening in Los Angeles, San Diego on that station. This is a big show, and you need to, yeah, it's WNOX, thank you, 100.3, a huge station. The point is, however you're listening to us, whether it's shortwave, satellite, internet, terrestrial radio, which is 90%+ of the radio audience, I want you to call your friends and family and tell them to tune in right now, because we're going to cover some hard core information that is so incredibly important on so many fronts. Where to start? All I want is fair elections, okay? I hated Al Gore, cannot stand Al Gore. As much as I don't like the mainline Republicans, Al Gore is probably my least favorite person on earth, okay? But clearly there was some fraud against him in 2000. I mean, it was there. It got certified in Ohio that was fraud in 2004, later, with Bush Kerry. People went to jail over that. This stuff is real. This goes on. I'm here to tell you, we've got reports, arrest happening, of people voting multiple times all over the country for Obama, of mentally ill people being lined up and they're putting voting machines in the mental institutions. This is coming out all over the country. I have that in my stack to have them vote for Obama. New York is announcing they are going to keep election polls open. I knew there was a scam going past Tuesday. There you go. That is postponing the election. CBS 2 New York, New York City Board of Elections. It's possible voting may be permitted beyond Tuesday in that key swing state. Romney, according to multiple scientific university breakdowns that have been proven to be totally accurate, like University of Colorado at Boulder with their computers, is set 76% to win the popular vote. What is it, 59% they're saying to win the electoral. Romney is beginning to go ahead in Michigan, Ohio, Minnesota, and Colorado in all the major polls. He is either tied or surging. Romney, if you look at this, Mitt Romney is set to win and be president. But in the Electoral College and also in the popular vote, it's hands down he's going to win in the popular vote, but Electoral College is what matters. So all I do is go with the facts. And I'm here to tell you, you've got the bookies in Vegas, in Ireland, and in England all over the news, and the media is carrying this already paying out, and I'm going to get to this with the proof and the articles, give you the headlines, all of it, coming up after break. The bookies are already paying out money Friday, Saturday, and Sunday tonight. They're already paying out on Obama. There's Business Insider. Irish betting site calls race early. Pays out Obama vote. Victory bets 2 days early. It's already starting all over the world with one of the most famously seedy industries. I mean, beyond that, trying to tell us what's going on, okay? We've got that going on. We've got that happening. We've got Cramer. I mean, you know, give me a break. How many times has that guy suckered people? He's saying Obama with a landslide. The media, the New York Times is running some questionable poll, sweethearts with the Democrats, saying 85% chance, you know, huge victory with Obama. All of this happening. Meanwhile, thousands of tweets going out saying burn cities, kill white people if Obama loses. And we, when we come back, Bill Maher, we're going to cover this first, is saying black people are going to attack white people, calling for racial division and race war if Obama loses. And so is Michael Moore. We have the proof. Stay with us.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Ben Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
Aaron Fullen here. As the food police shut down food co-ops, the Amish and small farmers, Americans are losing access, not just to raw milk and homemade cheeses, but to healthy, home-crafted sources for fermented foods like sauerkraut, yogurt, and kefir. It seems there's a war on life-giving foods with living enzymes and healthy bacteria. But frankly, I'm not sure what the food police are so afraid of. These remarkable foods have been around since the beginning of history, with archaeological evidence for fermented foods and beverages being found across the globe in almost every culture. Even today, Japanese eat miso, Africans eat fermented porridges, Koreans eat kimchi, and in India, fermented milk is a staple for healthy living. But here's some good news. Self-reliant Americans can now discover the secrets to making these amazing fermented foods legally and privately in their own homes. Since it's still legal to make these foods as long as you can make them yourself. For more information, check out fermentationfactor.com. That's fermentationfactor.com. It's easy to create your own powerful fermented foods, and you can do it by going to www.fermentationfactor.com. That's www.fermentationfactor.com.
The Silver Lungs Generator is the only all-encompassing professional class product for producing endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. With recent regulations threatening the sale of silver-based supplements, now you can secure yourself and your family by producing your own silver solutions anywhere, anytime. You can have the peace of mind knowing that you can create endless supply of silver anytime, anywhere, for any application. The Silver Lungs Generator is a one-time purchase that requires no maintenance nor replacement parts for the life of the unit. This product was designed to be an invaluable part of your vital preparations. For a detailed report on the differences between ionic silver, colloidal silver, and what most silver solution manufacturers are producing, please visit our website at www.silverlungs.com for more information on why you should be producing your own silver solutions right from your home forever.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. fact is, you can eat at any time to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
From the front lines of the information war, it's Alex Jones.
Monday through Friday, from 11 a.m. until 2 p.m. Central Standard Time, that's 12 noon to 3 p.m., we are live on the radio weekdays. And there's a lot of news happens on the weekend. There's a lot of people out there who are just at the mercy of the mainstream globalist media. And so we like to invade the airwaves Sundays, 4 to 6 Central, 5 to 7 Eastern. Okay, let me go ahead and get into the nastiest stuff I've seen in this 2012 election cycle, as we are only 48 hours out now from election night. We're not even 48 hours out from election day. We are 48 hours out. Probably by 8 or 9 Central, the mainstream media will be trying to project their winner. So we can say about 48 to 50 hours from now, 51 hours from now to be technical, we're going to be hearing who the winner is probably. Unless, this is the big news, there's a lot of it here. New York City Board of Elections, it's possible voting may be permitted beyond Tuesday. Romney's been surging in all polls the last 3 weeks, but a little bit of slowing in the surge and some reversals now. They're chalking up to Obama-looking presidential with the hurricane. We're going to be getting into all that in a moment. But this is big because postponing election allows more rigging, especially by the incumbent. And, you know, that way then machines can be reprogrammed, people can vote repeatedly, they can run voter rolls again because they'll have a data tape or they'll have a computer program that they can then flip. We've got Bev Harris, the expert in election fraud. You know, they made the HBO documentary about her hacking democracy. As she points out, both parties do it. She's going to be on with us tomorrow. And then on the election and the aftermath of the election, all 3 days, tracking this with us on the weekday show. Now, you know, 2.5 weeks ago, we began to track Twitter comments saying that if Obama loses, that people are going to riot. And these are Twitter accounts, some of them with 8,000 plus tweets, real accounts up for years. Some of them are new, might be spoofs, but there have been some Secret Service visits, some arrest. But Weekly Standard and others are pointing out that a lot of the accounts have been left up and are still saying they're going to kill Romney. They're going to go to wherever he's at and kill him, close quote. Before the media clips that out, I didn't say that. I'm reading the tweets. Believe me, they'll do anything, folks. We got to be careful here. It just goes on and on. Now we broke that. DrudgeReport.com blasted it out to make it a national story. And I was attacked by the Media Matters Group, run by George Soros in the White House, publicly funded by Soros, run by the former White House transition director. And they just said it doesn't exist, or I'm evil, or I'm bad. And they had Think Progress, run by the Soros group, publicly come out and attack us and say we were being racist. Now, let's get one thing straight. I am only 38 years old. I grew up in Dallas, Texas, so I have no guilt. I didn't grow up during the civil rights movement or all the stuff that came before. And I'm sick of being told I'm racist because I'm white. And it also makes me uncomfortable. It makes me angry because I have black friends. We got black folks that work here at Infowars.com. And it's just, it's the system trying to get everybody at each other's throats. And Obama was a grand chance to be able to bring unity. But the system doesn't want unity. The system wants division. It was a record number of blue-eyed white devils, as we're called in the past by you know, some of the people that are now on MSNBC, to bring everybody together. But it was the evil white people, I'm being sarcastic here, that got Obama elected. Okay? And I have seen literally thousands of tweets. We've done like five articles that have gone nationwide saying rioting, killing, attacking, calling for rioting during the storm. The media, Atlantic, Time Magazine, Salon all said we were insane, that the tweets weren't real and nothing would happen, and that there was, it was a myth that there was looting. Atlantic Magazine said that last Monday. What have you seen? Unprecedented looting up and down the East Coast, muggings, attacks. I haven't even gotten into government not being able to deliver services. The breakdown, now 6 days in, power still out to 3 million or more, 2.5 million in New York alone. This is bad. And we're going to learn the aftermath later because the media is trying to cover it up right now. You know, they tried to cover up the whole Benghazi thing. They tried to do everything they can to get Obama reelected. And that's just a fact. You know I'm nonpartisan. I call it like I see it. Makes my job easy. So with all of this going on in the backdrop, I mean, I am so sick of on YouTube, real accounts, real people saying I'm unsubscribing to your channel because you are racist, you don't like Obama. And I go to the person's site. It's a real site, up there years, real people. So ignorant. So ignorant. So ridiculous, because the corporate media pushes this idea that you're racist if you don't support government-run healthcare. I've seen Chris Matthews say it's racism and people hate black people is why they don't want Obamacare. I've seen them say gun control is good and you're a racist if you're against it and stuff like this. You've all seen it. You've all heard it. And then I saw today from Friday up on Infowars.com. We have it linked. Also saw it at Drudge and Breitbart. I couldn't believe it. Bill Maher saying black people are going to come out and attack white people like it's funny if you don't vote for Obama because it's racist not to. Here's that clip. And then we will, after we play that clip, we will get to another clip.
I would just like to say for anyone thinking about voting for Mitt Romney, if that's who you are, if you're thinking about voting for Romney, I would like to make this one plea. Black people know who you are, and they will come after you.
So there you go. Let's play that. Let's play that one more time. Let's back that up, and let's play that one more time. And I went to his site. The whole thing's up there, and he goes on with more jokes. This is, I'm telling you, the Democratic Party wants racial division. It's the big city model of dividing everybody into groups. They want a gang mentality, and this is what they push 24/7. Let's play that clip again.
So I would just like to say for anyone thinking about voting for Mitt Romney, if that's who you are, if you're thinking about voting for Romney, I would like to make this one plea. Black people know who you are, and they will come after you.
So there you go. We're going to go to break here, and then we're going to come back with a piece that we've had to bleep, but it's unedited other than bleeps. Michael Moore's produced a whole string of these with black people and whites and Hispanics saying they're going to rip Mitt Romney's testicles off and burn U.S. cities if Obama is not reelected. And this is being put out by George Soros, is funded. He funded the whole thing, basically. Move on. MoveOn.org. And I mean, it's so crazy because I remember, this was in the local news at the time, I caught a guy paying $300 a piece to young black males, a white guy, to have them go up before the legislature and say, we're, you know, basically gang members and you need to ban guns because it allows us, you know, using black people as a way to scare folks to vote for gun control, which was actually what I saw as racist. And the Statesman called me at the local paper and said, are you racist? Would you have put this report out if they would have been white? And I said, of course I would have. They were being paid off. Later, the Texas Ethics Commission said it was illegal. But that's what they do. You just say anything, they say you're racist when they're the ones pushing it as a control mode. Stay with us. We'll play the next clip when we come back.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure. And it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Cold and flu season is upon us. Protect yourself with Supernatural Silver, a revolutionary new broad-spectrum antibacterial. Recent advances in silver technology have resulted in a silver solution that can be used daily to prevent bacteria, viruses, mold, and food poisoning, as well as help improve wound healing. Silver Sol technology is safe enough to consume every day, while powerful enough to destroy the causes of many serious diseases, like strep throat, staph, pneumonia, colds, flus, and other harmful pathogens. This new technology is much more effective than colloidal or ionic silvers and has the ability to terminate entire colonies of harmful bacteria at several hundred times the effectiveness of older solutions. Supernatural Silver is what you need for any emergency. Go to SupernaturalSilver.com today and use the promo code AlexSays for 20% off. And like us on Facebook.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. The fact is, you can eat at any time to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
I have sworn upon the altar of God eternal hostility against every form of tyranny over the mind of man. Thomas Jefferson. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
You know, I'm going to be honest with you. I know Woody Harrelson. I like Woody Harrelson. I'm not criticizing him for the movie. But, you know, a movie like White Men Can't Jump. Imagine if you came out with a movie with some pejorative towards black men and said black men can't fill in the blank. Why is it good and cool in the media, in the culture, everywhere to run down white people? I don't like watching anybody get run down. I don't like racist jokes about anybody because we're human beings and I believe in this species and I want to empower humanity. You know, I've complained about what's so popular now in comedy, I've discovered, because I've been to comedy shows. I listen to XM. I'm on XM channel 166 weekdays. I hear a bunch of these so-called comedy radio shows. They make fun of, you know, people who are handicapped. And how ugly and gross they are, and you know, and oh, this woman wrote children's books when she was in an iron lung, and you know, they sold hundreds of thousands of copies. Oh, her family must have hated her. Oh, she's ugly and gross. Oh, let's abort babies. Oh, let's get rid of retarded children. You know, it's this ugliness, and I don't like it. And I'm sick and tired of the Democratic Party of Margaret Sanger and David Rockefeller, who on record have funded eugenics and abortion. You know why they got abortion legalized and how they got a bunch of white people behind it? Back in the 1970s, they said, go look it up. They said, we got to get rid of these black people. 52% of black people that are born, 48% are born, 52% are killed. Look it up. Over 50% of blacks are never born in this country. And we can play the abortionists, you know, that clip that came out this year, telling people, well, we want to get rid of the black babies, the, quote, ugly black babies. Don't believe me. Just type in ugly black babies into YouTube and it will come up. Okay, this is what I've been told over a decade ago when I had time to go protest at abortion clinics. Yes, I've done that. It was like 15 years ago I did it some. And they would come out and say, you're not going to adopt these ugly minority kids, are you? And it'd be a minority telling you this, like in the latest video. So I've been around leftist blacks, and I'm like, hey, you know, it's wrong. They're aborting your people. And they'll be like, well, I'd have five kids if I hadn't aborted. There's nothing wrong with that. This is sick. This is sick. And then we're told that if we don't support in our face, we're told that if we do not support, this is so amazing, that if we do not support Barack Obama, even if I did support Obama, you can't now under this threat, that you're a racist and that black people are going to come out and physically attack you. Now, that's what Bill Maher's saying. That's what these tweets are saying. That's what people with established YouTube channels are saying. Facebooks are saying, and they're not getting in trouble by and large. And that could be the October surprise. That Obama doesn't get elected. They say the storm caused people to not be able to vote. And then they say it's contested. And that's what a lot of people, you've seen in the news, are coming out and saying right now. They're saying that if this election's contested, there is going to be cities burning. And what an amazing idea. That if you don't vote for somebody because of the color of their skin or if it's contested, cities are going to burn. And then the power structure is going to use that to take our liberties and take our freedoms. Now, I'm going to play the Bill Maher clip again. But first, let's play one of a bunch that have been produced by the self-propelled stomach. Michael Moore, who hates capitalism but has made hundreds of millions of dollars gross, kept tens of millions himself off of the free market system that produced all of the incredible freedom we have. And there's a reason Hollywood, you know, grew up. America had freedom of speech. Other countries didn't. Here he is saying you don't pay enough if you make $125,000 a year. But here he is exempt from all these taxes. This is what he produced. This was put out a week and a half ago, and I'll assure you, if I put something out like this about Mitt Romney or about Obama, I would get arrested and you would get arrested because this isn't a joke. This is old women talking about ripping the genitals off of Mitt Romney and burning down cities. And they cut to a guy in Spanish saying, yes, we can. And with very serious look in their eyes, as if it's scaring everyone. Oh, my gosh. And then this is where America's going. Turn in your guns. We'll burn down your cities. On and on and on. America being held hostage by this. Here's the clip. Shows a group of old people.
I was born in 1915 during World War I. My first vote was in 1940 for Franklin D. Roosevelt. And I have not missed an election since. And I want the Republican Party to know if your voter suppression throughout this beautiful country enables Romney to oust Barack Obama, we will burn this down.
Si se puede.
I have four generations of family on this earth, and my life has been very blessed. And if the Republicans steal this election, I'm going to track down Mitt Romney and give him the world's biggest punch. What's the matter, Sonny? You never heard that phrase, punch? Right in the...
She symbolizes ripping the testicles off.
I served during World War II.
And they say this is the greatest generation at the start.
My buddy's still here, and I've got a message for kids, for Democrats, for anyone who cares about honest elections. If you let the Republicans do this to you again, after we die, we're going to look down on you from heaven, and we're going to make a point of watching you have sex every time.
That's enough. I can't watch any more of it. I can't watch any more of it. Did you miss it? She said, we're going to burn this mother effer down. Excuse the coverage of that, but that's what's being said here politically. If you put him in, they're implying that it's a fraud when all the polls, I mean, like 98% of them, show Romney surging everywhere. And you know I'm not in love with Romney. I'm not pushing Romney. I've been critical of Romney. But I do cover the facts when they present themselves. And casinos, betting parlors, all over the world, I'm going to cover this in the next segment, already paying money out from England to Ireland to you name it, saying that Obama's already won. That would be like if I got up here on air and said, hey, Mitt Romney elected the 45th president of the United States. You see, I'm not confident and feeling good about myself because I happen to come from European and some Native American derivation. I'm not proud of myself because I vote for Mitt Romney or Barack Obama. I'm not in identity politics. You see, I'm into people's souls, their minds, their intellects, who they are. And I could admire people who are Asian, who are white, who are Hispanic, who are black. I admire people by the content of their actions, by their deeds. I mean, I admire the incredible dynamic literature and scientific inventions and other prowess that I see from black Americans in this country, despite the Democratic Party trying to make sure they were cut up in their mother's womb. And then I take real umbrage by the race baiting and race pushing and racial division of Al Sharpton, slimeball Chris Matthews, Carlos Watson, all of them. It is disgusting to turn on Comedy Central and see Hispanic comedians up there trashing white people all day. And it's meant to make white people not like Hispanics. And it's meant to make black people not like whites. And it's meant to have Hispanics not like whites. It's meant to have us all at each other's throats while these foreign megabanks rob the living daylights out of our country. And I'm telling you folks right now that Obama wrote letters back when he was a U.S. senator 6 years ago that are on record to his Muslim cousin Odinga saying, if you don't win the election against the Christian majority in Kenya, these are public, you can just pull up Obama letters to Odinga, senatorial letters. He said, have riots and they'll give you a position. He was given prime ministership. They created that position in the Kenyan government. And I'm telling you, if they'd ship guns into Mexico to kill thousands of people to blame the Second Amendment, they are capable of anything if they'll get up on TV and say, white people, blacks are going to hunt you down and beat your brains out and burn your cities down.
Aaron Fullen here. As the food police shut down food co-ops, the Amish and small farmers, Americans are losing access, not just to raw milk and homemade cheeses, but to healthy, home-crafted sources for fermented foods like sauerkraut, yogurt, and kefir. It seems there's a war on life-giving foods with living enzymes and healthy bacteria. But frankly, I'm not sure what the food police are so afraid of. These remarkable foods have been around since the beginning of history, with archaeological evidence for fermented foods and beverages being found across the globe in almost every culture. Even today, Japanese eat miso, Africans eat fermented porridges, Koreans eat kimchi, and in India, fermented milk is a staple for healthy living. But here's some good news. Self-reliant Americans can now discover the secrets to making these amazing fermented foods legally and privately in their own homes. Since it's still legal to make these foods as long as you can make them yourself. For more information, check out fermentationfactor.com. That's fermentationfactor.com. It's easy to create your own powerful fermented foods, and you can do it by going to www.fermentationfactor.com. That's www.fermentationfactor.com.
The Silver Lungs Generator is the only all-encompassing professional class product for producing endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. With recent regulations threatening the sale of silver-based supplements, now you can secure yourself and your family by producing your own silver solutions anywhere, anytime. You can have the peace of mind knowing that you can create endless supply of silver anytime, anywhere, for any application. The Silver Lungs Generator is a one-time purchase that requires no maintenance nor replacement parts for the life of the unit. This product was designed to be an invaluable part of your vital preparations. For a detailed report on the differences between ionic silver, colloidal silver, and what most silver solution manufacturers are producing, please visit our website at www.silverlungs.com for more information on why you should be producing your own silver solutions right from your home forever.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Aaron Fullen here. As the food police shut down food co-ops, the Amish and small farmers, Americans are losing access, not just to raw milk and homemade cheeses, but to healthy, home-crafted sources for fermented foods like sauerkraut, yogurt, and kefir. It seems there's a war on life-giving foods with living enzymes and healthy bacteria. But frankly, I'm not sure what the food police are so afraid of. These remarkable foods have been around since the beginning of history, with archaeological evidence for fermented foods and beverages being found across the globe in almost every culture. Even today, Japanese eat miso, Africans eat fermented porridges, Koreans eat kimchi, and in India, fermented milk is a staple for healthy living. But here's some good news. Self-reliant Americans can now discover the secrets to making these amazing fermented foods legally and privately in their own homes. Since it's still legal to make these foods as long as you can make them yourself. For more information, check out fermentationfactor.com. That's fermentationfactor.com. It's easy to create your own powerful fermented foods, and you can do it by going to www.fermentationfactor.com. That's www.fermentationfactor.com.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
It's just so wrong that the Democratic Party, the party of slavery, I'm not even a Republican, but that they always lecture me about how I'm racist, how I'm inherently bad because my ancestors were European predominantly. I have quite a bit of Native American on my dad's side from different sides of his family, which I'm proud of that heritage. I'm just so sick and tired all day about how hearing I'm bad. And I realize that less sophisticated gringos, white devils, whatever you want to call me, less sophisticated El Diablos like myself are going to just constantly hear how they're racist and they're bad all day, and they're going to get racist towards people. And that's wrong. The globalists want divide and conquer. I really want to bring people together. I want humanity together to colonize the stars. I care about children no matter what color they are. By the way, after we play this clip again, can you guys pull up the clip from 2 weeks ago where Bill Maher said, I want more death, more abortion, get rid of the people? Yeah, we'll try to find that clip, because there he's really letting you know what this is all about. And again, I'm not saying the Republicans are going to save you. They're globalists too. But at least they have to act like they're pro-Second Amendment and pro-property rights. I'm going to get into the hurricane, the latest on the election here, and how all this ties together. But, you know, it's been proven that there was going to be looting. The media said I was wrong a week ago. It's been proven that there are thousands of real tweets saying burn down cities, kill Mitt Romney if he wins. And the media is still criticizing those of us that cover this. And now you've got Bill Maher and you've got Michael Moore and a bunch of other people saying that it's racist and whites should be attacked. And then I see articles, it's always regional news, never national, where you'll have white kids at a county fair beat up because they're white. And you know what? It's embarrassing to me when I read history books and hear about groups of white people beating up black people or worse. And it's embarrassing, too, to see the media sit there and cover it up when newspaper reporters get racially attacked. It comes out the papers won't run it. Because political correctness does not mean unity. It means people in their different divisions with the government playing the part of referee. So here is the clip of, one more time, from last Friday, Bill Maher on HBO. And HBO is so destructive. I've called for a boycott of it. I have had it deleted off of my cable system. My satellite system is what I have out in the country. Because they had a thing 3 months ago that showed four-year-old children performing fellatio on sex toys. You don't believe me, just look it up in the news. They want to destroy our families. They want to just fry everybody's morals so government can do whatever it wants. That's the name of the game, to where no one knows up from down. Let's go ahead and go to this clip of Bill Maher one more time.
So I would just like to say, for anyone thinking about voting for Mitt Romney, if that's who you are, if you're thinking about voting for Ritter, I would like to make this one plea. Black people know who you are, and they will come after you.
Okay. And we're going to cue it up to the First Lady in the Michael Moore piece saying, we'll burn this immer effer down. You'll see her say, we'll burn this bleep bleep down. We have to, obviously, for radio FCC here, you know, you're only allowed to do that on, you know, cable if you're Bill Maher. We can't do that here. Plus, I don't want to. I've got plenty of words to describe what I have to say without using the lower English. Okay, now, all of that said, while they're cueing that up, let's look at what we're talking about here. Here is a clip, and we'll get to this off the news. This is CBS News Sacramento. Veteran pollster fired over protest against UN observers. These aren't UN observers going to look at the machines or going to look at the companies. No, they want to make sure a bunch of illegal aliens can vote without IDs. This is out of California. They've got the NAACP in Houston openly running things. That's in the news. CBS 13, a poll worker is out of a job, and she says it's all because of an email she sent her supervisor saying, hey, isn't it illegal to have the UN inside the polling area asking people questions? It's illegal for anybody to do that. That goes back to the civil rights movement when people try to stop folks from voting. Texas threatens to arrest international monitors sent to watch U.S. election. That's from finalcall.com. I think that's Louis Farrakhan's outfit. And then here's another one out of the Examiner. Texas, Iowa threaten United Nations officials with arrest. MSNBC, Texas bans UN observers because its polling places are already perfect. So they're like pushing that it's a good idea. Okay, so there's that. Listen, we need the American people to get in there and get rid of these black boxes where the companies have been caught engaged in fraud and they can flip the votes and all this is happening. That's what needs to happen, not have the UN who's involved taking down countries. But because the media says they're loving and good, they must be great. Now, here's another report out of Breitbart. Is the Secret Service ignoring threats against Mitt Romney? And then it goes over the huge background of that continuing to happen. I mean, if somebody jokes at a Halloween deal and has a couple presidents in spider webs, you know, Bill Clinton and Obama, the Secret Service comes. We saw that happen a few weeks ago. But if you say, I'm going to physically punch Mitt Romney in the genitals and then rip him off, and I'm going to burn down cities, well, that's okay. And if you go on Twitter and say how you're going to shove a gun in Mitt Romney's mouth, close quote, or blow his brains out, close quote, that's okay. That's okay. Folks, we've had the Secret Service here multiple times asking us, well, you're putting a film out about Obama being a deception. What do you think of Obama? Get out of my office. You're supposed to be here over some comment on my, you know, on, by some user. Get out. Get out. Listen, they're there to intimidate the American people's free speech. Let's go to this clip one more time from the Michael Moore piece. We heard the whole thing earlier, but here's an excerpt of it.
We will burn this down.
No, no, that's great. Yes, we can. Actually, back it up 10 seconds before. I know I said cue it right up to her, but yeah, I want the full thing about if you elect Mitt Romney, because electing him's fraud, then we'll burn this, bleeper down. Let's go ahead and play that clip. Here it is.
And I want the Republican Party to know, if your voter suppression throughout this beautiful country enables Romney to oust Barack Obama, we will burn this down.
Si se puede.
I have four generations of family on
this
earth.
Let's just stop right there.
And my life.
She goes on to say she's going to rip his testicles off. Folks, here's the deal. They have all those old people. Those are real, you know, old folks. It looks like they're on death's doorstep to me, staring at the camera. And they're saying, yes, we can, in Spanish, with pure hatred. This is incitement. There is no doubt about it. No doubt about it. And I've always called for nonviolence. I've always called for a peaceful restoration of our republic. And I've had the Secret Service here three times. I've had the FBI here. I've had the ATF here trying to stir stuff up. I've had the FBI in there, came with the Austin police, point right at the wall and say, what's that? That's an Obama deception poster. What is that? That's a film. You know what that is. Well, what do you think of Obama? And I'm just like, you need to leave. You need to go. Well, wait, we were trying to find. Get out of my office, man. First Amendment. What is it you don't understand about it? Stop urinating up and down the Constitution. While a bunch of people sit there and say they're going to rip Mitt Romney's testicles off and burn U.S. cities, you're sitting there. It was years ago they were here. They haven't been back in a while. The point is, I read about it all the time. We're talk show hosts. Well, I've had them on. Have been arrested and put in mental institutions because they criticized Obama. Because they can't put you in jail. They put you in a mental institution. Marines have been arrested. All of it. We've covered it. And I'm telling you, these are authoritarians trying to take over. And if Mitt Romney gets in office and tries any of this, I'm going after him. But Mitt Romney will be facing re-election. And Mitt Romney will have a lot of conservatives trying to keep him on a short leash. He is a globalist. Obama has gotten away with Fast and Furious. He's gotten away. I can play the clips from earlier this year. Three separate congressional hearings saying NATO and the UN are in charge of our military and Congress. He doesn't have to consult Congress about war making anymore. And now you got all the bookmakers running around saying, oh, we're already paying the money out. Obama's winning. And now, coming up, and then we're going to open the phones up and got two special reports as well. Gary Johnson, the Libertarian presidential candidate, is going to speak out on the Bilderberg here for the first time. New York City Board of Elections, it's possible voting may be permitted beyond Tuesday. Hey, the headline should be possible election to be delayed. Oh, my gosh, ladies and gentlemen, I haven't even gotten into government, not able to deliver anything and help the people who were there begging. By the way, Nimmo did an article about the woman pathetically begging Schumer, the gun grabber that's in Featured News Archive. I want to get that clip of her begging Schumer. Help me. These people didn't even get prepared or ready, and they go up and beg and plead. A lot of New Yorkers and folks in New Jersey, they got ready. But what did you think? All the government's going to do is take your guns and put you in a slave camp. You got that, Jack?
Cold and flu season is upon us. Protect yourself with Supernatural Silver, a revolutionary new broad-spectrum antibacterial. Recent advances in silver technology have resulted in a silver solution that can be used daily to prevent bacteria, viruses, mold, and food poisoning, as well as help improve wound healing. Silver Sol technology is safe enough to consume every day, while powerful enough to destroy the causes of many serious diseases, like strep throat, staph, pneumonia, colds, flus, and other harmful pathogens. This new technology is much more effective than colloidal or ionic silvers and has the ability to terminate entire colonies of harmful bacteria at several hundred times the effectiveness of older solutions. Supernatural Silver is what you need for any emergency. Go to supernaturalsilver.com today and use the promo code AlexSays for 20% off. And like us on Facebook.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. The fact is, you can eat at any time to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
If you just joined us, I'm marveling at thousands more tweets. I was talking to Watson today. There's just thousands more how they're going to kill Romney, close quote. Kill him, and hey, he's going to be in this area. Let's go kill him, close quote. Secret Service does almost nothing. Seen a few arrested people where they were like in the town a mile from him. And hey, let's get our rifle and go get him. They arrested that guy. I just marvel at that I've had the FBI call my office and ask about the Obama deception, and then show up about something else but ask about the Obama deception. A film that says Obama's a puppet. And then meanwhile, these people can do all this. Listen, I'm not intimidated. If you think you're intimidating me, you better check yourself a little bit, because it's not having that effect. I am absolutely sick and tired of the New World Order. I am sick and tired of dumbed down people, black, white, you name it, playing into it. And I want it to stop. I've got a big stack of news here where government cannot deliver and cannot help people because government doesn't know how to do that. I was on the hike and bike trail hiking with my wife today. And while she was taking the dog in the creek where there was some water to take a drink, I was hanging back and I was listening in the woods to city workers in plain clothes having a little secret meeting, and they saw me and scurried off. They were talking about how to raise more revenue, what they were going to do at the city council. I don't know who they were. They were government people, because the city's in all this trouble for secret meetings. And the county attorney has said, though, well, just don't break the law anymore with all your secret meetings. So I'm down there. I just cannot go anywhere. I didn't even have my cell phone on me or I'd have tried to videotape it. These folks are going, well, we've got to raise the revenue this way. We can do this. We can bring this to the council. Yes. And all of a sudden they see me listening. Like, oh, and like ring race, the three of them drift back down the woods. So I'm doing my job if the bureaucrats have to go hide in the woods to have meetings. And then what's the chances, CJ, that I would be down there? Because this went on for a couple minutes. I mean, I was like creeping up. I was only like 10 feet away by the end by a tree listening, down on the Barton Creek Greenbelt. Pretty darn amazing, but that's a side issue. When we come back, I'm going to give the number out. David Ortiz interviewed Gary Johnson a couple days ago. We're going to premiere this here on the radio coming up. We premiered it on TV first Friday night. We're going to premiere it here for the radio broadcast. It's just some excerpts, a 30-minute interview. I'm talking about Bilderberg, New World Order, and more. It's pretty darn powerful. And I covered this some on Thursday and Friday. The Supreme Court's now hearing, hey, can they just have a police dog come up to your house without a warrant? And if it says it smells something, we're going to come in without a warrant. I mean, come on, folks. We had a family experience just Friday night. Saturday morning, opening day of deer season. That is so unbelievable that I'm not even going to talk about it on air until it's been dealt with. This country's far gone. There's a reason I didn't go out to East Texas to our old ancestral family ranch because of the craziness I've seen in those areas. But what happened on the opening day of deer season was so beyond bizarre that we're all pinching ourselves. Government is now showing up and declaring they own people's land, having delusions, like the TSA stripping down naked and beating their chest and saying, I have power, I have power. It's stuff like that. And it's going to get worse because people are now disconnected from reality. And those of us that are still somewhat connected, doesn't mean we're perfect, but we at least have some tenuous connection to it. We're going to be the bad guys. So there is just a lot of insanity taking place around the world. We're going to go to break and come back and get into what the latest poll numbers and what's really happening with the election. And then we're going to get into what really happened quickly with Sandy and the big aftermath there and the talk of postponing the election, keeping early voting going with the whole Bloomberg crime syndicate up there and what they're up to. Just unbelievable. This whole thing stinks to high heaven. And then we're going to go to your phone calls and two special reports with David Knight and David Ortiz. So it is all coming up. Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.tv.
Strategic relocation is a systematic way to think strategically in the future about how do I safeguard.
Renowned author and expert, Joel Skousen.
The U.S. isn't building huge underground bases and bunkers because of some terrorist threat. They know that a massive nuclear attack is coming. They want that attack to come.
Joel Skousen is renowned as one of the world's foremost experts in strategic relocation and the securing of your home.
What I tell people is that you do have time. We talk about natural disasters, the health environment. We talk about pollution, the water quality. My personal experience about being in every one of these states, most people won't even be ready and won't be able to get out of town because there'll be absolute panic.
There is no preparedness without strategy. This Christmas, give the gift of preparedness. Strategic Relocation, the film, with Joel Skousen and Alex Jones. Available only at InfoWarsShop.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
Monday through Friday, 12 noon to 3 p.m. Eastern. We're here back Sundays live, 4 to 6 Central, 5 to 7 Eastern. That's 2 to 4 Pacific, 3 to 5 Montana, as in Tony Montana. All right, here's the deal. If you just tuned in, we've got Michael Moore. There's like five videos I've seen. We've just aired one because we only don't have time to bleep all the cuss words out of the others, I'll be honest. In fact, tomorrow, let's get the rest of the Michael Moores and have the sound crew bleep out all the cussing. Saying physically rip the genitals off of Mitt Romney if he wins and burn down U.S. cities. Quote, we will burn down U.S. cities if he's not elected, if Obama's not elected. And they cut to a guy in Spanish saying, yes, we can. What's the translation of that? Si se puede. I mess it all up. Si se puede. Did I finally get it right? Yes, we can. The point is, I played it like twice. I'm not going to play it again. It's up at Infowars.com. We played it like a week ago because there's now a new Bill Maher clip where he says, hey, white folks, vote for Obama or black people are going to hunt you down. And again, it's always white liberals who aren't liberals. They're limousine pimps who always support abortion, which 50%+ of blacks get aborted. Oh, yeah, you didn't know that? Always pushing how great and how wonderful it is to attack white people. And then we've done big reports all over the country, racial attacks being goaded by the media that it's a good thing to just haul white people out of their cars in Pennsylvania, Ohio, California, New York, and beat them up. And let me tell you know, people, if they got on the news and told whites to go beat up black people, they'd probably do it. I mean, people are easily influenced by the media. The globalists want racial politics. And you've got all these people that feel dependent on government and they don't know how to make it without government. And they are so angry thinking that Mitt Romney wants to take their goodies. When all I saw Mitt Romney do was brag how much he was going to increase Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid, and all the goodies, and how much he loved them. Those poor people don't understand. They work their whole lives, and they'd probably get, on average, what, double, triple? Some studies show the money. By some show three times, four times. Most show double the money if you invested that in a guaranteed 4% return. But they steal your money. And listen, once the political class has enough people on the dole, they're just going to vote to take everything we've got. Our guns, our children, our lives. The Democrats are promoting a national draft. Rangel and others. They're monsters. And again, the Democrats are absolute monsters. The Republicans are horrible globalists as well. It's just that the Democrats are so much worse. So you're like, well, then do we vote for Republicans? Well, no, because there is our damnation. The Republicans of today are like Democrats 25 years ago. The Democrats have taken us so far on the Overton window and learned helplessness and the normalcy bias towards absolute tyranny. And they always have the moral high ground. You don't like government-run health care? You're a racist. How many times have you heard that? And meanwhile, the Democratic leaders are on there saying, we're going to burn down cities if Obama doesn't get elected. And you know what? The Democrats are happy. If folks in inner cities burn down their neighborhoods, that only makes them more dependent on government, doesn't it? That's why they admit they came out with a great society and said, we'll pay you not to have a man in the house so we can break up your family and put your man in prison. Because that creates illegitimacy. That creates poverty. That creates crime. They've destroyed the black community. 90%+ illegitimacy. Did you know I've looked at the numbers? You can pull these up. Just type in black illegitimacy lower than white illegitimacy in 1950. I was all for ending segregation, ending stuff like that. But the system they brought in was even worse because you had thriving black communities, Christian communities that were rising, and the system didn't like that. The big monopolies didn't like it, and they went in and they destroyed it. And now look at it. It's a wreck. And they took the gangster culture. They projected into that as cool, where the only way you can make money was in crime, and they projected it into all our communities. Doesn't matter what, quote, community you're in. They bombard you with this garbage. Now, let's talk about government here. Before I get more into the election, your calls, here is the toll-free number on any of these issues for first-time callers on this Sunday edition, 877-789-ALEX. Different number on Sundays because everything's produced out of here. Weekdays, it's out of Minnesota. Even though I'm here in Austin, they do the phones up there. 877-789-ALEX, 877-789-2539. 877-789-2539. And we'll get you up and on the air. We got two special reports coming up. Breaking news with Gary Johnson, who we talked to on Friday. Libertarian presidential candidate talks about the New World Order and more. But let's just go through these headlines here. New York Times. In New York's public housing, fear creeps in with the dark. Yeah, because you've disarmed everybody, broke up the families. Doesn't matter when the power goes off in places like Texas. Because let me tell you something. We've got more weapons than the Pentagon. There's only looting around here. No, but oh, poor New York, great city, great people. I've been there many times. Chicago, great city, great people, but run by crime bosses, highest crime rates in the country. Chicago, highest crime rate in the world. They got Mexico City beat up there. And our great 1530 listeners are up there listening to us every day, and they agree. Continuing, Daily Mail. Misery for 2.5 million still without power after 6 days as lawlessness and fear take over New York's outer boroughs. What did I tell you? Last Sunday and Monday, myself and Paul Watson wrote articles how the looters were planning racial attacks and looting, and we got video of people being racially attacked, you name it, and the media won't even cover it. It's in little local news blurbs, but not a national story. Continuing here. Batman, run looters, people fighting them with bats. Look at this photo right here. Look at this amazing photo of your PrisonPlanet.tv viewer. People are fighting off looters with bows and arrows. Because you're not allowed to have guns, but you're allowed to have a bow and arrow. Don't worry, Bloomberg will have that banned now that you notice that happened. Mafia kings only want, and that's, you know, globalist New World Order, telling you what you can drink and eat, telling you you can't have guns. I mean that's tyranny. That's government crime. Queens residents arm themselves with post-storm blackout from looters. Government isn't there, can't protect you. Basically, police standing down. Where's document cam? I'll put it there for people right here. I mean, look right here. I mean, this is amazing. Look at this. Hurricane Sandy leaves frenzy for gas, though help on the way. Chaos reigns as free gas fiasco. Government said, don't worry, we're going to deliver you all this free gas. And then everybody showed up and there were traffic jams. There wasn't enough gas for even 1% of the people. Government can't and won't deliver to you. But I've got articles here where they go on to admit people are defending themselves with baseball bats and bows. And now government, 6.5 days into this, is saying, okay, we'll now pay private contractors to bring in food, water, and other things. And now New Yorkers, I have an article here in the Stack, are demanding concealed carry. Let us protect ourselves, man. The criminals have guns. New York faces massive housing problem after Sandy, governor says, CNN. Devastated Rockaways residents lash out at Bloomberg during unannounced visit. Lights in lower Manhattan, misery in outer regions, the lights are off. Well, they're turning the lights off in Europe, saying it's for carbon taxes because the extra money, you have to pay more for energy to pay to Al Gore and others in their Rothschild-owned carbon scam. But, oh, the lights are off for other folks in New York. Oh, isn't that too bad? But the financial district's being protected. Get used to all the lights being off in the new dark age, because everything, they're going to take all your money and make you pay giant property taxes on a giant tyranny, a little cracker box home. That's Agenda 21. And it goes on and on and on, how they're having to get private groups in there, private contractors in there. Look at Katrina, where they did have guns, the government came and took them. Oh, you're high and dry, you got a generator, we see your lights are on, up against the wall, we're taking your guns, you saw it. All the guns will be taken. No one will be allowed to be armed. I need to play those clips again. Now, coming up, we are going to get into the latest election news, the real polls, and what they show. And then your phone calls, as well as Libertarian presidential candidate Gary Johnson. We're going to premiere him talking about the new world order. I'm Alex Jones, and we are the Resistance.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
Cold and flu season is upon us. Protect yourself with Supernatural Silver, a revolutionary new broad-spectrum antibacterial. Recent advances in silver technology have resulted in a silver solution that can be used daily to prevent bacteria, viruses, mold, and food poisoning, as well as help improve wound healing. Silver Sol technology is safe enough to consume every day, while powerful enough to destroy the causes of many serious diseases, like strep throat, staph, pneumonia, colds, flus, and other harmful pathogens. This new technology is much more effective than colloidal or ionic silvers and has the ability to terminate entire colonies of harmful bacteria at several hundred times the effectiveness of older solutions. Supernatural Silver is what you need for any emergency. Go to supernaturalsilver.com today and use the promo code ALEXSAYS for 20% off. And like us on Facebook.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. The fact is, you can eat it anytime to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locked locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
He aligns himself with the truth, and it's time for you to choose a side. You're listening to Alex Jones. My love is in league
with the freeway. Okay, I want to go to your phone calls. Again, we have two special reports that are short but very important coming up, dealing with the end of the Fourth Amendment or the expansion of that move, and also Gary Johnson, the Libertarian presidential candidate, his take on the New World Order. Pretty important stuff. With our own David Ortiz and David Knight both reporting. First, I want to go to some of your calls after I hit this news as quickly as possible. If you just tuned in, I'm seeing stuff that's just, well, quite criminal. And it means they've been given authorization to do it. I will assure you, Home Box Office, HBO, MoveOn.org, and others, they would not be saying riot, burn down cities, attack white people if Obama is not elected, unless this was some type of plan. And you would not have thousands of people on Twitter calling for violence and burning down cities, not getting in trouble or almost not getting in trouble in all cases, if they weren't being given protection by the Justice Department. The same people that ship guns into Mexico on record to blame the Second Amendment, the same people that have been involved in, well, just so many crimes, it makes my head spin. You know, we're moving into this phase now in America where the globalists have committed so many crimes with the banker bailouts, the insider sweetheart crony deals, that they want to just go ahead and take over because they know that if the American people, black, white, Hispanic, Asian, ever together, who love liberty, ever come together and get our country back and realize that big government is not the way to prosperity, it's the way to bondage and tyranny, if we ever come together, they know they're all going to jail. And so we're at a crossroads here, and it doesn't mean that Mitt Romney's going to save us. It's just that if Obama gets elected, he will not be facing re-election, and he will go hog wild. He will have the power of the executive order unbridled. He will have the power of the pardon. And I see the power structure right now trying to rig this. Again, I've seen articles out of England, articles out of Europe, articles out of Las Vegas, articles out of Ireland, here's one of them. Irish betting site calls race early, pays out Obama victory, bets 2 days early. So selling the idea that, oh, the, you know, the famously seedy gambling industry, they say. Jim Cramer, Obama is going to obliterate Romney in a historic landslide, despite the fact that all the polls show the opposite. They're getting you ready for a stolen election. Nat Silver, Obama's odds of winning have now hit 85%. With 2 days to go, Obama's odds of winning re-election have reached their highest level ever. Really, I thought there was a surge by Romney. Again, I'm just reporting that they're telling you something here that's butt backwards. According to New York Times polling guru Nat Silver, I mean, the New York Times, they told us about WMDs in Iraq. They've had their own people quit and go public that they're ordered to lie. Total cost of election, New York Times reports, could be $6 billion. It's already over $4 billion. Gee, do you think there could be some chicanery going on if they'll spend billions of dollars on this, all these interests, including foreign governments? Gee, you think they might be manipulating the betting houses to pay out early, even if they have to pay out to others later? Won't be in the news. Then everybody will forget. Gallup poll, Romney holding 5-point lead among likely voters. The Hill. But so what if Gallup says that? Here's the University of Colorado Boulder. Analysis of election factors points to Romney win. University of Colorado study shows. Doesn't matter they've been right in the last five elections since 1980. Let's just ignore scientific reports because, hey, the gambling houses, they say it's Obama. And by the way, he's a Peace Prize winner, even though he's launched more wars than Bush. Gallup, Romney up 52-45 among early voters. That just came out a couple days ago. But let's just ignore all that because, we all heard Cramer, who's told us to invest in so many things that turn out going the opposite direction. I'm sure he made a mistake. It's not like he was pumping and dumping. He wouldn't do that, even though he's on video admitting he's pumped and dumped. Just type in Cramer admits he's committed crimes. Cramer admits he's pumped and dumped, and you'll see him bragging about it. Romney gains ground in latest poll of swing states. Of course, nowadays, you don't go to jail when you pump and dump. Look at Facebook. We told you that was a pump and dump. It loses half its value in a week. It did. Romney gains ground in latest poll of swing states. Maintains lead nationally. Isn't that funny? That's what out of the Associated Press. Momentum. Romney increases lead in national swing state. Poll show. Here's another one. CBS News. National and in swing states. Romney Obama in neck and neck. Even CBS that's pro-Democrat has to admit it's, quote, neck and neck, which isn't even really the case. Here, let me show you some more. Let me show you some more of these headlines. Dead heat for Romney and Obama in latest Michigan poll. Yeah, they're showing the one where it's a dead heat. Most show Romney winning. Trib poll shows presidential race in Pennsylvania remains too close to call. Romney was 10 points behind a few months ago. Our choice for America's future. The Daily News endorses Mitt Romney. New York Daily News. Doesn't matter. Freudian slip. Candy Crowley calls him President Romney. Daily presidential tracking poll. Rasmussen. Again, shows Romney continuing to be in the lead. And it goes on and on and on. Let's continue here. But that doesn't matter because there's going to be extra polls held open longer in the big rotten Bloomberg run Apple where he tells you what you can eat, where he tells you you can't have a gun, where he had checkpoints set up with people trying to get in to get their families. You got to have three or four people in a car to come in here. Turn around. Sir, my wife got stuck in the city. She didn't even turn around before I club your head in. I got a reporter I don't have time to get to. The TSA is now wearing uniforms that look military. This happened to a Lou Rockwell writer screaming at everyone. You're like, well, that's outrageous. They want to get you used to it, okay? This is what tyranny looks like. You haven't experienced it yet because your forefathers would rather die than be slaves. We became jellyfish. We acted like sheep. The wolves came. When you roll over and make dying sounds in the middle of the woods and, you know, northern Canada, big timber wolves are going to come rip your throat out. When you act like a man, they're going to run in fear. Like with grizzly bears, you stand your ground or you run at them. Then you got maybe a 95% chance of living. You run, you're dead. You understand that? You got to face these people. Can you guys, if you can find it, pull up David Knight's EPA Alex Jones analogy. It was only like 2 minutes long. It was so good. I think we heard that on the weekday show, but it's so good. What's the name of that? We can call David too. One of our great reporters. It's EPA Alex Jones analogy. I forget the exact name of it. Let's just call David Knight. That'll be the quick. All right, I can call him during the break. We're about to go to break. New York City Board of Elections. It's possible voting may be permitted beyond Tuesday. This is big news. I mean, that means a postponed election. That means all the lawyers involved. That means time in these states controlled by the Democrats, where Romney's winning in Michigan, in Colorado, in Ohio, in Minnesota, where traditionally Democrat, where the Democratic Party runs things. Now they're going to have a chance to fix things while the wait is on. Oh, yeah. Just like the Republicans fixed things when Ron Paul won Iowa. And Maine, oh, you bragged. The Republicans even bragged they stole it. That's how arrogant they are. Well, now they get to have the same thing back. So that's all coming out. Four men arrested in Pittsburgh for stealing Romney signs while driving a sheet metal truck. We got other reports. Las Vegas woman arrested trying to vote twice. You guessed it. We're going to come back, ladies and gentlemen. But they're already telling us Obama, he's won the 2012 election.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Aaron Fullen here. As the food police shut down food co-ops, the Amish and small farmers, Americans are losing access, not just to raw milk and homemade cheeses, but to healthy, home-crafted sources for fermented foods like sauerkraut, yogurt, and kefir. It seems there's a war on life-giving foods with living enzymes and healthy bacteria. But frankly, I'm not sure what the food police are so afraid of. These remarkable foods have been around since the beginning of history, with archaeological evidence for fermented foods and beverages being found across the globe in almost every culture. Even today, Japanese eat miso, Africans eat fermented porridges, Koreans eat kimchi, and in India, fermented milk is a staple for healthy living. But here's some good news. Self-reliant Americans can now discover the secrets to making these amazing fermented foods legally and privately in their own homes. Since it's still legal to make these foods as long as you can make them yourself. For more information, check out fermentationfactor.com. That's fermentationfactor.com. It's easy to create your own powerful fermented foods, and you can do it by going to www.fermentationfactor.com. That's www.fermentationfactor.com.
Alex Jones here with a very important announcement for truth seekers. We've carried a lot of amazing films and books over the years on the online video bookstore at InfoWars.com. And out of all the titles we've carried, one stands out because it is just so chillingly convincing. And that's Dreams from My Real Father by Joel Gilbert, available at InfoWars.com. This film exposes the fraud that Obama is like nothing I've seen. If you want to know who Obama's real daddy is, this is the film for you. Don't forget, your purchase supports our broadcast and our growing media network. You'll also find at InfoWarsShop.com, None Dare Call a Conspiracy by Gary Allen, the book that woke me up. We're also carrying Behind the Green Mask, UN Agenda 21, by Rosa Corey. This book is coffin nails to the globalist takeover. The Greater Good, the most professional and up-to-date film I've ever seen, exposing the scourge that is vaccines. These titles and a lot more are all available at InfoWarsShop.com.
The Silver Lungs Generator is the only all-encompassing professional class product for producing endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. With recent regulations threatening the sale of silver-based supplements, now you can secure yourself and your family by producing your own silver solutions anywhere, anytime. You can have the peace of mind knowing that you can create endless supply of silver anytime, anywhere, for any application. The Silver Lungs Generator is a one-time purchase that requires no maintenance nor replacement parts for the life of the unit. This product was designed to be an invaluable part of your vital preparations. For a detailed report on the differences between ionic silver, colloidal silver, and what most silver solution manufacturers are producing, please visit our website at www.silverlungs.com for more information on why you should be producing your own silver solutions right from your home forever.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Leading a frontal assault on the lies of the New World Order, it's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Smoke on the water, fire in the sky. All right, we're going to go to your phone calls, and we've got two short special reports in the final segment coming up. We'll also take calls next segment. But since I mentioned it, That liner says leading a frontal assault on the New World Order. And that's the answer. We're the good guys, whether you're old, young, whether you live in New York City or Los Angeles or Austin, Texas. If you love freedom and you love choice, then you should support the Constitution and Bill of Rights. Not that we ever implemented the whole thing, but it's really a good idea. That's why it's under attack by authoritarians worldwide. And I'm going to play a couple reports put together, a new one premiering in here by David Knight, the same reporter, and David Ortiz, coming up in the next segment. But you know, I talk about coyotes. Coyotes have not been recorded until recent times to kill people. But I go all over Austin because I'm a big hiker, and I see signs everywhere saying, you know, where's my cat? Where's my little dog? Well, coyotes ate them. But the very same liberals don't want anybody to shoot the coyotes. So the coyotes know, come into Austin with the green belts and eat your small dog, eat your cat. People have had their large dogs attacked by packs of coyotes and had their, they do the same thing the Democrats want to do to Mitt Romney in that clip we played. They rip the genitals off, the nose off, you name it, if they're not able to kill the animal. And coyote attacks are at record numbers. But I saw an article last year out of Arkansas where a woman was at a park, ran from coyotes, and they killed her. See, if you run from a predator, it thinks you're prey. But if you stand up to it, it will back off 9 times out of 10. Same thing with polar bears, grizzly bears. You roll over in fear, you're dead. You stand your ground and thump your chest, it's going to think, well, I'm going to leave that alone. That doesn't look like a seal. That doesn't look like prey. That looks like something ready to get it on. If you hold a stick up in front of a bear like it's a gun, they're animals are smart, folks. I can be out in the woods without a rifle, and there's squirrels all over the place barking at me in a tree. But I grab a stick and act like it's a rifle, they're all gone. Crows up in the top of a pine tree will shut up. I'm a hunter. I know these things. I'm a primitive man. I'm also advanced. You see, when I'm primitive, it gets me back to my roots, which allow me in this modern world to excel because they've trained you to be a jellyfish. The answer is to get back to our roots of being wily and smart. None of us want to be domesticated. Nobody's selling us on a free lunch wants to really give us a free lunch. They want to run our lives, and that goes for Mitt Romney and Barack Obama. So David Knight broke down this parallel between, if you're listening on the radio, he shows video when he talks about the bears, what to do of Alex Jones, myself, and others out there protesting. The video is called EPA Lies About the Smoky Mountains. They say the Smoky Mountains are smoky. The old Indian word meant Smoky Mountains. It's haze, hot air and cold air hitting. But they say it's pollution. That's why they're smoky. So pay Al Gore money. Here's the clip.
I'm David Knight, reporting for InfoWars Nightly News. Just before I left for Austin, I took my family to the Smoky Mountains. Now, long before the Europeans named it the Smoky Mountains, the Cherokee had a name for it. And if I pronounce it correctly, it's something like Shaconoque, which means place of the fine particulate smog. No, not actually. That's what the EPA wants you to think. I was surprised to see this graphic on the EPA site where they explain what PM2.5 is. They use the Smoky Mountains as a poster child. Is it really PM2.5 and man-made smog that makes the Smoky Mountains smoky? No. We all know that it isn't, but we see this kind of thing done over and over again, like they did with polar bears on ice floes. Remember that? And, of course, Al Gore is telling us that the oceans are rising, but he builds his $9 million mansion in Montecito, California, right on the ocean side. So I don't think he believes that either. But they use these subliminal messages to try to convince us. And they can be quite effective. And speaking of bears, every visitor to the Smoky Mountains gets a handout that looks like this, warning you about black bears. And as my wife was reading that to the small children, I started thinking, a lot of the stuff they were saying about bears could be said about government, especially about the EPA. Let me just read a few things here. With aggressive behavior, the bear, the EPA, is demanding more space. If the bear or EPA continues to follow you, stand your ground. If the EPA gets closer, talk louder or shout at it. Act aggressively. Act together as a group if you have companions. Make yourself look as large as possible. Don't run, don't turn away, and don't feed the EPA. It only encourages further problems. David Knight for InfoWars Nightly News.
Okay, let's go to your calls as quickly as possible. Lucas, Dan, Greg, Dave, Bozer, Scott in D.C., and others. We'll get to all of you if we have time. Lucas, in FEMA Region 5, I'm in FEMA Region Texas, Texas. Oh, it's FEMA Region 4 now? Texas is FEMA Region 6. So, Lucas, where are you in FEMA Region 5?
Indiana.
All right, buddy. What do you think of all the stuff we've covered today?
You've done a great job, as usual. Same situation we were in, 2008. Two puppets to choose from. I choose neither, but I just want to let you know that I'm a huge InfoWars supporter. I'm a Prison Planet TV member. I hand out your DVDs all the time. I turn a lot of people on your websites, and I've had a lot of success waking people up with your information.
Well, God bless you, sir. Indiana is really waking up. We've gotten a lot of information from Indiana. Again, I know Romney's a globalist as well. My point is, what do you make of talk of trying to get race riots going by the media? I mean, if you or I went on air and told people, riot if Romney doesn't win, we'd be locked up. Why is Michael Moore allowed to do that?
As you pointed out, it's a divide and conquer tactic, you know? Obviously, they want people out at each other's throats rather than paying attention to what's going on above them. But, hey, I wanted to point out there's a major story that I think needs your attention, and the alternative media has kind of missed it. And
tell me.
Okay, there's an article on Activist Post. I don't want to plug a website or anything like that.
I don't care. Activist Post is a nice site. What's it reporting on?
The article is titled Obama Doctrine, the New International Order, and it's an analysis of the national security strategy of 2010, and it's all about this new international order and giving more authority.
Oh, no, they've said the UN and NATO commands our military. That is a big issue. I've got congressional hearings where they say NATO is now over our military. We might come to Congress, but we don't need you. It's unbelievable treason. I will pull that up. Guys, pull up Obama Doctrine at Activist Post, and I will get that lot of great stuff over on their site. So we'll look into that. Anything else, sir?
No, that's where the Libya policy came from. That's why we had the Secretary of Defense saying, you know, we can go to NATO or the UN. I wrote this article for InfoWars. I tried to get it through email, but it's, I know you guys are swamped with news tips.
So yeah, there you are, Lucas Bowser, contributor.
Yes.
Okay, well, we'll look at it and see if we can get it up. Our guys are working to get all the good articles up, but that's interesting. We'll look into that, and if you want, we'll post it up at InfoWars.com. Thank you so much. You can always post it at PlanetInfoWars.com, the social network as well, PlanetInfoWars.com. Thank you, sir. Let's get to one more before the break, then I come back with more breaks. After the break. Let's go to Dan in New Hampshire. You're on the air.
Hey, Alex. Thanks a lot. I just want to say I've been a fan for years. You do a great show. I love what you do. I believe I'm up here in FEMA Region 1.
Yes, you are.
Manchester, New Hampshire. And got a lot of things going on with the election. Obviously, I think it's pretty pretty cool that Mitt Romney's going to be here in Manchester tomorrow night. He's doing a concert at the Verizon Center with Kid Rock. And I thought it was interesting because he's here the night before the election. Almost New Hampshire is a huge battleground state for him, but there's not too many electoral votes.
Who is Kid Rock pushing?
From what I understand, it is a Romney event in which Kid Rock is performing. So,
well, that's not a very good endorsement for Romney.
No,
I mean, I'm not bashing Kid Rock, but just give me a break.
Right. It's just another pop culture supporting, you know, whoever is there.
What do you think of all the calls for race war by the Democrats?
Oh, I find that very interesting. I feel pretty safe here in New Hampshire, but I don't. I'm pretty surprised that they're lashing out and basically.
Well, yeah, it's a form of terrorism. Exactly. It's unbelievable. They're criminals.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices.
The cost to feed livestock is forcing farmers and ranchers out of business, blowing up your food prices. The only strategy to counter this is to freeze your food cost at today's prices by getting your own supply of foods from eFoods Direct now. As the price of raw ingredients increases, eFoods will have to raise prices too. Now is the time to get your supply. I recently increased my supply from eFoods Direct because we have all known this was coming. You know about their delicious long-term storable foods. The fact is, you can eat at any time to save money today. And because it stores for 25 years, you're locking in today's prices and avoiding the rising food cost. Don't wait. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Cold and flu season is upon us. Protect yourself with Supernatural Silver, a revolutionary new broad-spectrum antibacterial. Recent advances in silver technology have resulted in a silver solution that can be used daily to prevent bacteria, viruses, mold, and food poisoning, as well as help improve wound healing. Silver Sol technology is safe enough to consume every day, while powerful enough to destroy the causes of many serious diseases, like strep throat, staph, pneumonia, colds, flus, and other harmful pathogens. This new technology is much more effective than colloidal or ionic silvers and has the ability to terminate entire colonies of harmful bacteria at several hundred times the effectiveness of older solutions. Supernatural Silver is what you need for any emergency. Go to SupernaturalSilver.com today and use the promo code AlexSays for 20% off. And like us on Facebook.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Waging war on corruption.
Crashing through the lies and disinformation. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
I'm up here in space. I keep my eye on you. My lasers trace everything you do. You think you've private lives, think nothing of the kind. There is no true escape. Big Brother's watching all the time. The NSA is elemental. Its sight is clean. It is perpetual. It keeps the country free.
All right, I'm going to stop singing. I apologize. The NSA is run by foreign banks, and it's here to make sure the global crime syndicate can take over and ship drugs into the streets of our country. That's the truth. There, I just translated the Judas Priest for you. Briefly, before I go to some calls, and then one of the reports that the David Nine will have to air tomorrow on the police dogs coming in your house without warrants now at the Supreme Court. Strategic Relocation, the new film I produced with Joel Skousen along with his book, is now available at InfoWarsStore.com. And every order gets a free citizen rule book full of evil American terrorism stuff like a Declaration of Independence. Learn about the safest areas of the United States or the world, for that matter, at InfoWarsStore.com. Strategic Relocation. Let's go to Greg in Oklahoma, then Dave in Missouri, Scott in Colorado, and others. Greg, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi, Alex.
Welcome.
I want to talk briefly about the election, but first I've always wanted to tell you that God loves all his children, just like any father loves all his children, but he's more proud of a lot of them than others, and he's definitely proud of you.
Well, I try my best, brother. Thanks for putting up with me. What's on your mind?
You're a good man. We're middle class. I gave about 3% of our income last year to InfoWars and Ron Paul. And when I saw how he was treated by the Republicans, I swore I wouldn't support Mitt Romney or whoever won for the Republicans. But I've changed my mind, and I want to give you a few quick reasons why. First, there is no opposition to the current regime except from the Patriot movement and the weak-kneed Republicans. If Bush had tried to do about half of what Obama's done, they would have had the left up in arms about it. We need the opposition of the left and the anti-war.
I agree. The left used to hate drones and secret arrest and checkpoints and wars. Under Obama, they just say, look, this guy, you know, is part African-American. Let him do whatever he wants. I mean, it's horrible.
Exactly. Second, I don't think that preppers are going to be the victims of the same opprobrium under Romney, if for no other reason than he's a Mormon and part of his faith is to be prepared.
No, exactly. Obama has completely shifted away from the boogeyman Al-Qaeda to saying the number one threat is veterans. I mean, how do they get away with saying veterans are the number one terror threat? I mean, they shouldn't even be on the list of terror threats.
It makes no sense either because, what, hundreds and hundreds of thousands of veterans have come back. There's been no terrorism.
The only way a veteran's going to be a, quote, terrorist if you try to take their guns. They resist, they're going to be called a terrorist.
That's right. The third reason, the last one, is I'm just so upset about all these threats of rioting and all the subtle threats and intimidation that comes from
the
left.
Well, it isn't subtle when you got all these people. MSNBC, but mainly Slimeball, but you've got Marr, and you've got the self-propelled stomach Michael Moore saying burn down cities, attack white people. I mean, let me tell you, you got First Amendment, you don't have a right to call for violence, and I think they both need to have their butts arrested.
I agree. I think if Romney is elected and we see rioting and whatnot, I think we need to know that. I think we need to know where are we as a country? Are we at the place where somebody that's as heinous and lawless and authoritarian as Obama, if he doesn't get reelected, people are going to riot? We need to know that.
Listen, I'm sick of every time Nightline, MSNBC, New York Times is in my office. They say, don't you feel bad you're going to cause violence when I'm calling to peacefully restore the republic, while their people are the ones that always push it. That's what I'm saying. It's not just that they're lying about me or you. They're then doing it. I'm sick of it. I've had the FBI here over this while they're running around doing it, blaming me. I appreciate your call. Great caller. Great points. I want to go to a few more, but here briefly before we go to who's up next, Dave and others. Here is part of the report with Dave Ortiz, one of our reporters, and Gary Johnson on the New World Order. Here it is. InfoWars Nightly News.
Now, in your opinion, Governor, is this world run by a handful of powerful banks?
In my opinion, this world is run by a powerful group of whether they're bankers, whether they're media. They are people that are in charge of what we hear and what we think and what we're able to do in ways that are completely undetected by all of us. And this is the opportunity here with this election, with the next election. Voting for me, I think, is to really just give that one the swiftest boot in the rear end that you could possibly give.
Now, Governor, obviously you were a former governor. Have you heard of the Bilderberg Group? And if so, what are your thoughts on this group?
You know, I've heard about it. I've done some Wikipedia is what I've read about it. And I don't have an opinion, yay or nay, as to their significance. But I was excluded from debates in the Republican primary. This was a decision that occurred in boardrooms. Who made those decisions? I can't tell you who made them, but they were made, and they were made in ways that excluded me unfairly, and nobody was able to even notice that happening. I could point to hundreds of different reasons. It would only be a guess, but this is an example of how our lives get controlled by individuals that own the world, if you will.
Okay, but you don't know what goes behind, you know, behind closed doors, these Bilderberg meetings.
I don't, and I know that you all offer conjecture on that, but I sure don't.
What were your thoughts on the presidential debates, what both candidates had to say?
All right.
Just much to do about nothing. I mean, when you've got...
Yeah, exactly. I agree with Gary Johnson. It was like both bragging how much, you know, which side will give you more government. If you want to see the whole 34-minute interview with Gary Johnson, talks New World Order, Bilderberg, and Bohemian Grove, it's up at InfoWars.com right now, or just Google Gary Johnson Talks New World Order. Let's cut that off now, though, because I promise to go to more calls. Dave in Missouri, real fast, brother. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. Great job in all that you're doing. I'm one of those veterans that swore to uphold and defend the Constitution from enemies, both foreign and domestic, and I refuse to vote for any liar who's going to get up there and say that they do the same when they support the Patriot Act, which is a direct violation of the Fourth Amendment, NDAA, and
which both of them support it. Yep.
Both of them do. I flat out refuse to vote for anybody that's going to get up there and lie with the very first thing they do as president. So I'm going to vote for Gary Johnson and help him try to get that 5% so that will open up doors that will bring down the left-right paradigm.
Well, there's no mistake that the New World Order agenda continues to move on no matter what we do. Both parties are bought off. It's just the Democrats move us at light speed and the Republicans, you know, move us at sub-warp. It doesn't matter. We're going the same direction.
Correct.
So what do we do then? Just continue to expose these people?
Yes, that's the greatest thing. Maybe Obama being elected, that would help because it's going to wake up people quicker. I posted that on Facebook that I refused to vote for a liar, and I had a veteran relative say, oh, yeah, we need more people that believe like that. And then within 10, 15 minutes, he realized, well, wait a minute, that's Romney. And he supports Romney because he's not as bad as Obama. And that's brainwashed, and we've been brainwashed. You know, we have to stand up to him every way we can.
No, we have been brainwashed. Look, I said this earlier. If Obama gets elected, I go from 140 stations to 300. I mean, I will enter the Michael Savage, Rush Limbaugh level in the next year if Obama's elected. But I still get what you're saying about how it's lesser of two evils, but I still don't want Obama to get in because he told me in a debate he's going to ban my guns. I mean, he said it. He loves abortion. At least Romney now has to say he's against it. So I'm like, I've never been conflicted in 17 years on air, and I am conflicted because my gut tells me Obama is going to drop the hammer. But then, like you just said, maybe that's good. Just let's just get this thing on. Let's just get it all out in the open all the way.
I think that'll wake up more people the fastest. That may be our best hope.
Well, you know what? We're going to find out in less than 48 hours. 48 hours from now, they're going to start getting ready to announce on Tuesday night who the winner is. And I'm sorry. I apologize to Scott, DC, Jerry, and Jonathan. Call me back tomorrow. Open phones again, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central. If you want to find us out there, it's InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. And all I want is a future for my children. I think you want that no matter what color you are. The fact that the Democrats are calling for race riots and not getting in trouble is really scary. All right, great job with the crew. See you back tomorrow.
The worst drought in 50 years continues, and the first 6 months of 2012 marks the hottest half year on record. 78% of the Midwest Corn Belt is in drought conditions. Not only corn, but soy, alfalfa, fruits, vegetables, and wheat are all impacted, raising prices. The cost to feed